Okay, here we go. This is the traditional move everybody knows from Karate Kid. Hey guys, I'm Sage Northcutt. I've been doing karate since I was 4 years old, training martial arts. I'm a professional fighter. I am several time world champion in point sparring, continuous fighting, and the forms and kata. So today, we're gonna be checking out the Karate Kid from 1984. So let's dive in and I'll let you know what I think would work and won't work. Here we go. Okay, so right off the bat, that's a traditional bowing before the match. That happens in point sparring, continuous fighting. I've never known a match take place like this where you're blocking all the shots. Pushing after the break, that's definitely not legal, that's for sure. So that's definitely an illegal move. Not allowed. Definitely has some interesting stances, that's for sure. Sweeping in karate? I've never known a karate match to allow sweeping like that. Okay, so right there, that takedown actually looks like a scissor takedown. It's very similar to it. He just went from a different direction. That scissor takedown actually is an illegal move in judo and jiu-jitsu, I believe. So hitting those tournaments isn't allowed. And if you do it right though, it could definitely be a dangerous move. Once again, not legal in karate. Alright, so they're having a coach's timeout right now, it looks like. You can't call a coach's timeout in the sport karate, so that's definitely something that could happen.
You have a problem with that.
No, Sensei.
Alright, he's going back out to the match. Here we go. By the way, that scissor takedown is illegal for a reason, being that it can blow out your knees and hurt you real bad, so. Okay, so right there. That kick right there, faking towards the legs with one kick and come back up to the head, definitely a technique that works, that's for sure. I've had friends that have done that before in matches, and it's definitely something that works great. Once again, trying to stomp your opponent, that's definitely not allowed. I feel like he'd be disqualified by now, that's for sure. Alright. It's getting intense. It's hurt. They definitely have an interesting style, that's for sure. Definitely, I've never known a style to look like that. It's more like a movie style to me. Okay, so that move right there, that'd be a really hard move to hit. Spinning sweep, as your opponent's kicking, that'd be super hard. So I don't really see that happening much. That doesn't look like it would be effective in real life. Okay, so he's getting back up, match is continuing. Here we go. That is a sign of respect when your opponent turns away from you and kneels down on the ground if your opponent's hurt. Obviously, this guy doesn't have very much respect. You can see that right there. Do another illegal move right there. You can't catch a leg hit to the knee like that to break the knee or to injure your opponent. You know, I don't know if that move would work actually. Catching and hitting the knee, I feel like it could, but you gotta have some skill to be able to catch the leg for one thing, and then your opponent's gonna be trying to squirm out, especially in an MMA match. Okay, here we go. This is the traditional move everybody knows from Karate Kid. He's doing the crane right here. Him yelling, finish him? I don't know if karate instructors should yell that. Yeah, that's definitely a move that would be very hard to hit. I don't see the crane right there working in real life. Maybe if your opponent had a blindfold on, then you could hit it. But other than that, that'd be super hard to hit in real life and not very likely. It's more like a movie move.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.